Hey, a controversial new biography paints Prince Charles as a man who struggles with his insecurities and is burdened by an overwhelming sense of duty. The author of Charles, The Heart of a King, Catherine Mayer, joins us from our London studio. Catherine, a very good morning to you. You've actually spent quite a bit of time with the Prince. You've met with him, you've dined with him. Can you give us an insight as to what sort of person he is?
He's immensely complicated. That's the first point, really. He's somebody who is quite troubled, quite... he's somebody who can be really charming one moment and, as one of his friends said, you know, he's sunshine one moment and rain the next. So you don't necessarily know what you're getting. He's got a very complicated belief system and... he's really fascinating. He was a great person to write a biography of because he actually got more interesting the better I got to know him.
And when you say the better you got to know him, did you get permission? And have you put some noses out of joint with what you've written in your book?
It was not an authorised biography. I wouldn't have wanted to do an authorised biography. That means that you would have to show everything that you've written to that person for approval and let them rewrite it before publication. However, I did get quite a lot of good help from his organisation, his court, Clarence House, particularly when I was preparing a cover story for Time, which was the original seed of this book, if you like. But then they liked that cover story, so they continued to give me some assistance, both in helping me to speak not only to him but to his friends, and in the later stages of research, at least not stopping me from speaking to people or not stopping them from speaking to me, which is really important with a book like this.
Well, it's certainly a long labour of love, I suppose, in a way. You followed him for 2 years, but let's look at some of what you had to say in the book. You say that Prince Charles wants to rule differently to how the Queen rules. What changes do you think he'd want to make?
It's not so much that he wants to, is that it would be impossible for him not to. She came to the throne at 25. Nobody knew what she thought then, and nobody knows now what she thinks. He is a man who spent his entire adult life campaigning for all sorts of causes, you know, trying to change the world. He will come to this role if he outlives her, which is a big question, with a great deal of baggage. You know, people already know what he thinks about the environment, about architecture, about complementary medicine. That's not necessarily a bad thing at all, but it absolutely makes for a different kind of monarchy. And also, I would very much doubt, from what I've been told, that he would entirely detach from some of the organisations he's set up.
Interesting. And one of the really explosive claims you make in the book is that Charles had extreme cold feet, that he almost wanted to call off the wedding to Diana, just right up to the moment that it actually happened. And this is one of the things that I think has put a few noses out of joint. Tell us what you found out about that.
Well, it's funny because I would not expect that to have put noses out of joint in the sense that it speaks sympathetically of him. The standard version of the marriage has been that he, as a significantly older man, you know, he was almost 13 years older than Diana, that he had cynically led this young, trusting woman into a union which he knew would not be a successful marriage in the way that most of us understand it, but was instead a kind of dynastic union. Whereas what I understood the more I spoke to people who knew him was that the upbringing in the Windsor setting is so strange and so other that he was as young and innocent as she was in human years, if you like. I use this phrase, Planet Windsor, to try and convey exactly how different that upbringing is.
All right. Catherine, thank you for sharing some of your insights on Prince Charles. He certainly is a fascinating and complicated human being. And Catherine's new book, Charles, The Heart of a King, is in bookstores now. Thanks again, Catherine.
You're welcome.